Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder, or better known as ADHD, is a mental disorder that affects an individual's ability to focus, causing them to move around more frequently. They may also have trouble controlling their impulsive behaviors.
One time for them praying on my downfall. Yeah. Two times for the homies in the chow hall. Whoa. Three times for them hoes on the internet shitting on niggas when they really should get out more. Four times for the days I were all bad. Woo. Five times for the bitches so they call back. Yeah. Six times for the kids like me who got ADHD just to kidnap a nigga like ISIS. Whoa. Turn the whole world to a crisis. Whoa. Walk around the city with an ice pick. I've been paranoid, usually I ain't like this. Ain't no telling how crazy I might get. Beat the police with a nightstick. My whole life I've been lifeless. Now I'm so fly, I'm a motherfucking flight risk. Whoa. Fuck a couple hoes till I pass out. Whoa. Niggas throwing stones at my glass house. Whoa. I remember sleeping on my dad's couch. Whoa. Now I got the Bentley and it's blacked out. Whoa. Family looking at me like a cash cow. Whoa. Everybody dissing just a half clout. Whoa. Thought you had a chance, now you asked out. Nigga, I'm the motherfucking man, where you at now? Whoa. Fuck it, I'ma hit them till they jumping. I ain't tripping, this is nothing. I've been living in the dungeon. I done held a couple grudges. What the hell, I got a jack to meet the devil. I'm a cousin. I ain't settling for nothing. Got the metal in the truck, I keep the semi when I'm busting. Niggas ducking, even Stevie Wonder couldn't see it coming. I ain't judging, I just want the money. I don't need a budget. I've been hungry, I ain't got no oven, but I got the munchies, nigga. How you gonna move on the front line? If I don't fuck with you, I just cut ties. My high school teacher said I'd never be shit. Tell that bitch that I turned out just fine. And no, I don't know you for the 12th time. We do not share the same bloodline. You let it run your mouth like a tough guy. Hope you keep the same energy when it's crunch time.
According to the American Psychiatric Association, it affects roughly 8% of children and 2% of adults. Commonly believed to only affect boys because they are perceived
as rowdy and rambunctious.
One time for them praying on my downfall. Yeah. Two times for them bitches in the South Shore. Whoa. Three times for them days on the block getting chased by the cops like a motherfucking outlaw. Four times for them days that were all bad. Woo. Five times for the bitches who ain't called back. Yeah. Six times for the kids like me who got ADHD just to...
Jordan need a couple hearses. Double homicide, kill the beat, and the verses. Everybody living on the surface, but we came from the underground. Yeah, we deserve. What's beef? Beef is when you murder motherfuckers on a beat. Kill them all, nah, nah. What's beef? Beef is brothers lying over shit that never mattered in the first place. Lying in the street. What's peace? Peace is when you leave it in the past. Let it heal like a cast. When enough time passes and you blast. Kinda like John Wick, bars like a convict. Fuck a runner, you don't wanna start shit. Woo! Coming with the hot shit, all they do is talk shit. You can never top it, boy, just stop. High end drunk, call that HD vision. All these other...
I gotta close the window before I record, cause New York don't know how to be quiet. What? Stand up. What? Third.
Coochie down to the socks like I'm Biggie Popper. Keep your girl head in my Tommy boxes. But rent it out, she a silly hoe. Cause she know the Frankenstein getting plenty dough. She don't get nothing from my nigga though. All she get is hard dick and some Cheerios. Kinda send it out, but I never go. But I put them in the dirt with the penny low. No tint though, on my window. So you see a nigga shining in the Benzo.
Holy.
Got me feeling like Jim Jones. I'm a pimp though, no limp though. Couldn't copy my style in Kinko's. Put in work, run up on the killer, then I put him in the dirt. Run up in the building, see me gon' squirt. That's what a nigga get when they gettin' on my nerves. I ain't lying. Lay him on that curb, riding on the killer who be coming that firm. Girl, you twerk, twerk that kitty girl, make it turn. Put in work, Flacco, put him in the dirt. Fresh got the shovel, he gon' put him in the earth. Trinidad maniac with it all gon' hurt. Yeah, put in work. Schoolboy Q with a pound of the perk. So much work, he'll smoke up the earth. Polo Brown, ASAP.
With Assault Man. So we are, oh god damn it, I forgot to put that up there. But we are live, and I fucking forgot to do a thing. But we're live. I'm pretty sure they can hear Bran.
Fuck Billy!
Exactly.
Yeah, anything that goes wrong tonight is just Billy's fault.
I know we already watched this one.
Shits and gigs, we're going back.
But it's so excellent that I have to watch it again. Laughing at you, G-Man, not with you. At.
Just, it's this crazy tightrope that G-Man walks of, like, cringe content and things that just aren't acceptable. He does it well.
Yeah, my earphones are always crooked, Drew Lover. Thank you very much. Here you go. I'll be appropriate. I'll be sophisticated. I have to be sophisticated with this in my background. Yeah. He's literally flexing in a Goodwill shirt. Okay.
You should be more professional, Billy. You should be constantly fucking with your hairline, trying to cover it up the entire stream. Because that's what you do if this is your job. Are you really going to put Bronte on your fucking forehead? The quilted quicker hairline cover upper. Bounty.
There you go. I got my perfect bandana going.
You look like a Mennonite.
Oh, man. Still have a better hairline than Negs, though.
I'm gonna take that off. Churn us some Kerrygold, Billy. Churn us some Kerrygold, Billy. Come on, what are you doing?
Oh, okay, I'll turn on this video. Thank you all for showing up at a very random time and like almost impromptu bullshit. We do 100% appreciate it. Since you know we pay our bills with this, whatever G-Man thinks we do. With 45 people watching.
Take a look at Billy's mic. He's definitely got a job, and this is it, what we're doing right now.
This is clearly not my job.
You would have had to have saved several months of Geek Room Pay.
Oh, fuck. I'm going to play.
Yeah.
Get me a bologna sandwich with Swiss cheese on rye.
My favorite thing is, that's what G-Man thinks fancy people eat.
Right? He knows he can't say filet mignon, so he just went with what in his mind is the next best thing.
You know what my favorite thing on the planet is when people bullied him for so long that he started spelling the word jail. Because he kept on saying like he went for like a jail. Solid 6 months, like you're going to J-I-A-L. Or fucking he spelled it wrong. J-A-I-L. But like it was great, and because he kept them saying gel, and I'm like, you guys are fucking just terrible.
Gels and creams.
On the back that he's taking.
Don't make me repeat myself now. Yes, master.
This is acceptable, apparently.
Once again, not laughing at Drag, laughing at G-Man. G-Man, so you know this is funny because you're an idiot.
Yeah, it's really your incompetence at the end of the day that's really setting this off.
Okay, G-Man, stop talking about Shanny and me, or we will expose you for being gay. Give us money and booze and let us back into the house. God bless.
Is that your voicemail for Gary?
What's
right, Jason, don't hang up. G-Tart Translator 9000, activate!
G-Tart Translator 9000, activated. What is your command?
Jesus fuck.
There's not enough subs, okay? They could have a million subs. I would still argue there's not enough. Also, there's probably some... There's hilarity behind here. Like, there's nuggets in here, okay.
For sure.
Gary only speaks G-Tar.
Quiet, Jason. G-Tar Translator 9000. Translate Jason's voicemail from English to G-Tar.
Please select G-Tardation level.
Activate G-Tardation level 9.
G-Tar max settings confirmed. Is this message for Gary?
Yes.
Recalculating. Compensating for G-Tardation and low IQ due to fetal alcohol syndrome caused by Gary's rum-drinking prostitute whore mother.
At least she wasn't a Scranton hooker on Facebook.
She was a fucking Trenton hooker on Craigslist.
On Friendster.
Whatever was then at the time, fuck.
Translator 9000. Translate Jason's voicemail, then playback.
G-Tar translation complete. Commencing playback. Demons make me get, no, 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 and
Like a bunch of times. It's true though. This channel could have every sub on YouTube.
It's still not enough. It's so good. That shit, like the G-tar translator. It's one of my favorite things. Oh fuck.
I gotta get one of those.
Yeah, me too, man.
Hook it up to my email.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Sowing and Reaping YouTube channel.
We didn't finish this one because I know we skipped past it. I think we're like here.
Early on, help we those. Skipped it.
Frank is busy being in jail for beating his wife.
Help those guys.
Don't worry, he'll be out. I got him. This is East Carolina.
Yeah, this is here, East Carolina.
Bag here for them. I'm gonna bless them with this bag whenever I get an opportunity to go see them in person again, which may not be for 2 weeks. Okay. But I'm going to try to bless those guys. But when my
is he talking about blessing child abusers?
Oh, absolutely. What,
oh, you know, that's like if you had an option. So you're on the side of the road, and there's a hobo out there with a thing that's like, "Give me money," and then another hobo says, "Give me money," but they're also punching squirrels actively. And you're like, "I'm gonna give that squirrel puncher one because he has charisma." Moxie.
Oh shit. Be right back.
Now the show's just me. So welcome to the Tatted Geek Room show. Where we review stuff and things and we make sure that Bran is a bitch.com. Yeah, pretty much it. We're here watching the doofus say some stupid shit, and he was supposed to go live today. To invite me on, even though he has me blocked on his YouTube or StreamYard. Let's see if he's live yet. Was it Sowing and Reaping? G-Man activates anti-feminism mode. Okay, it looks like he's been deleting videos. 19 hours ago. Okay, well that was 19 hours ago. Okay. That's the one we were watching yesterday where he was arguing with, we had Godless Girl on. And, he already went live? Fuck, did I miss it? God damn it, dude. Did he challenge me? The royal BGTVs in my chat. That's pretty cool.
Don't be too royal. Bad shit's happening to those people lately.
Yeah, they get yeeted. To be fair, I think he's not 97, but you know the saying. Big gay dress. Okay, and I forgot that was his nickname if you're a fucking 5-year-old. Where I was going. Okay, so BGTV did have it. Okay, I'm gonna grab it. Thank you.
Oh, what do we got?
We got the newest from G-Man. The newest Sticky Icky.
Hot off the presses.
We'll have it ready. Oh, okay. The year's not ready. Let's see. Nope, it's not gonna let me do it. Okay. I'm just scanning through it to see if he does put up a video. Okay, I'm just going to hit play and play the audio through because I don't care.
Mm-hmm. Let's see.
I'm while doing what I do. But let me explain a couple of things and make a couple of disclaimers here. First and foremost, I am not here to defend Shanny for Christ and Revelation News. Let me say this again because this...
I'm going to make a bold prediction. He's going to defend Shanny and Riff.
I mean, it wouldn't be the first time.
Nah, it wouldn't be the first time he said that and immediately did it.
No, not G-Man contradicting himself in the same stream. No.
Sometimes in the same sentence.
Yeah, true enough.
always gets lost in translation. And since this is in the beginning of the video, people should be able to catch it. I am not defending Shanny. I am not defending Rev. Believe it or not, this has more to do with the hypocrisy of certain people in the...
What's that word now? Were you shooting for hypocrisy?
Live chat here so that you guys can find him. All right. I actually, back in the day when we used to do the great debate stuff, I used to promote people's channels all the time.
Oh, you mean the air in which you still live?
I used to promote people's channels all the time while doing what I do. But let me explain a couple of things and make a couple of disclaimers here. First and foremost, I am not here to defend Shanny for Christ and Revelation.
Planet on it.
Let me say this again, because this always gets lost in translation. And since this is in the beginning of the video.
Oh, so is that his new thing he's going to start saying a lot?
Yeah, it's like, well, the fool said in his heart there is no God, that fucking line.
Every time he learns a new word or a new, like, you know, phrase, he really wears that son of a bitch out.
Yeah, like next with the word fucking fallacy.
He tries.
Oh, dude, that's a fallacy. Which one, stupid? Point it out. You're fucking, like, if you're going to say the word, at least know what they mean. Say it.
Not defending Shanny. I am not defending Rev.
Third time.
Believe it or not, this has more to do with the hypocrisy of certain people in the reaction community.
Hypocrisy.
Okay. And it also has to do with Burnt Toast and Monty and some of the things that they claim that they're upset about.
I thought I was getting a shout out today.
What they think I've done and all this other stuff and whatnot.
You probably will eventually.
When he's reacting, yeah, he doesn't like what me. They say, they're not used to being challenged. Those of you are Christians and you're watching this, I know you probably are. No,
that's not true.
Listen, like, wow, look how
G-Man's challenged.
There's actually.
Are you proud of yourself for that joke?
Mm-hmm. Very.
That was his mom's fault for drinking.
Somebody out there actually.
His fault for not looking both ways before crossing the street.
I'm fine with that.
Typically, when you take on a YouTube troll, the idea is to ignore them and they'll eventually go away. You can't do that with the reaction people because they have been talking about me literally for years.
Yes, you can ignore everyone who makes these videos.
It's very not easy. Hard. Dude, we had like a fucking full year and a half of people making videos on us. You know how many fucking ones we reviewed? Like two of them. Like we didn't give a shit because we were like, oh, yeah. All of you are trash.
Everything we just waited until they did something like a new elevation of stupid. And then we'd comment on it. Other than that, they were just spinning their wheels.
And we were like, ah, oh, Billy's racist. Oh, how'd you know? It's like fucking we don't care. Like... Oh, look, Indiana Trash thinks I'm racist? I don't care.
Based on a video that was...
made in pure jest.
It's so fucking obvious.
Subscribe to PewDiePie. Well, this shit's legitimate.
Totally.
Not necessarily Burnt Toast or Monty. Okay, not necessarily them. But there are other members of the reaction community that have been talking about me literally for years. I'm talking over like 5, 6, 7, 8 years on here.
Probably like 2 for us.
Right. And how long have you been talking about drag there, Gary?
For about ever.
And it's my goal today to start letting people hear both sides of the story. So people don't just believe Burnt Toast when Burnt Toast makes a claim or when Monty makes a claim. So we're going to take a look at the stream that they did over there, and I'm gonna watch it again. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna respond, not to everything that's being said, to just some of it. Because
here's my you really gonna be watching a video where people just dunk on you the whole entire time?
Again, apparently.
I enjoy when he does that, but it's just, why? Like, why are you doing that?
Monty was in my room last night.
He's going to win somehow.
Monty had an opportunity to talk about whatever he wanted to talk about, right? Burnt Toast.
He wanted to talk about why the fact you want to release pictures of his kids.
Yeah, I think we would all like to know the answer to that. It's fucking weird, my guy.
Could have came on my channel, and talked about whatever she wanted to talk about. Instead, Berto's, like the coward she is, decided to send Jules in here to speak for her.
You did not know that was Jules until you watched the Geek Room the next day. There's no way in fuck you knew that.
Hook, line, and sinker. You got Gary.
You did, because you knew it was. You thought it was her fucking for hours.
All right. Whether or not the last thing I said was true or not is irrelevant. And let me tell you why.
I don't know what the last thing you said was. What was the last thing you said?
Like, I'm questioning if it's not true, then you're lying. What does that make you, Gary?
Fucking liar. Which is worse than touching
worse
children.
Than a pedo, Gary. So you better clarify if you've lied. According to your own standards, this could end not so well.
Or pretty well, depending on who you ask. Also, thank you everyone for showing up. We have nearly 100 people in the fucking chat. What's up? How you doing? David Anthony, Paige Lovelace, PT Ham, Mr. Unite for the Chill Wind, Druid Lovers here as always, Tito Canoe, sup brother, the Dude Brothers, never heard of you, the Comfort Doll,
I know the Dude Bros.
Do you?
Yeah.
They cool?
Yeah, he's cool.
Okay, Fit and Curvy, she's always around too, Sydney's always around, Druid Lover again. HHM, I think I said that already. Bad Brats here. David Anthony, I already said that. Let's see here. No one matters but cats, except for dogs. Dogs are better. Mrs. Parker's in the chat. Sup, Paige Lovelace, Joda, Melissa S. Okay, I'm just seeing repeat names. What's up, BGTV? He's in the chat as well. Todd Malakote's in the chat as well. Sup, guys? How you guys doing?
Thanks for joining us. Yeah, this really was more or less a pop-up. Yeah. Like, I know we normally do stuff, but, you know, it almost didn't happen. So,
I was running late, and Bran was busy beating his wife.
Is it passed on to me now?
No, I'm just making sure that you all are doing it.
Well, I think I'm behind, honestly. I should probably work on that.
Bruntos was given the link. Bruntos could have
cut the grass, too.
Bruntos could have got angry at Jules for imitating her. Bruntos did none of that.
Jules doesn't get mad because she dog walked you for 4 hours, making you look like an idiot, thinking you're talking to Bruntos.
So I came to the conclusion that Bruntos told her to come in this room. And that's using logic.
You can't tell fucking Jules what to do.
Something a lot of people in this community has forgotten how to do.
That is the worst person to tell to do something. Jules is not good at that.
Just don't know how to use anymore. And I'm gonna challenge the logic and the thinking patterns of a Burnt Toast and a Monty, who are not used to dealing with a strong Christian who has opinions and views just
Where?
Like they do. And when
Where
I disagree,
they?
I really disagree. But when I don't have a disagreement with you, I try to avoid the topic altogether.
Oh, fuck you.
You make a point.
No, you don't.
You just...
No, yeah, it's a different person that does that. That's not you, Gares.
Make a point. There's nothing to argue there. And I want people to understand something. They keep implementing me in a lot of the things that they're saying. When
implementing me.
Did he
implicating
say,
you fucking idiot.
It sounded like he said, wait, hold on, take that back.
He means implicating, really, dude.
Opinions and views just like they do. And when I disagree, I really disagree. But when I don't have a disagreement with you, I try to avoid the topic altogether. When you make a point, you just make a point. There's nothing to argue there. And I want people to understand something. They keep implementing me.
Unimplementing.
Yeah, but he's trying to say implicating.
Well, he's stupid, Billy. he's a fucking idiot. I don't know, I guess he got kind of close.
He got the first like few letters right, and then it was like, but.
Ah, fuck it.
And a lot of the things that they're saying on YouTube.
Like, his brain basically did the Google fucking guess for words.
I'm feeling lucky.
They're saying that G-Man's involved with child neglect.
Yeah, that's implicating, not
now,
implementing.
Some of them might look at that and say, that makes G-Man mad. Let's keep doing it.
No. We're not doing it because it makes G-Man mad. We're doing it because it's true and it makes you mad. Those are two things. Mm-hmm. It's both.
win-win situation.
100%. It making you being a bitch is fucking fine with me, but you're a bitch, mm-hmm. so either way.
Yeah, we didn't have to do that. You mm-hmm. did that yourself.
Yeah.
I don't think you understand. This has nothing to do with whether or not it makes you mad, happy, joyfully, joyful, or whatever. It has to do with you people lying and making stuff up, and you need to be exposed. And I believe...
yeah, but you're currently being exposed.
What's happening in this community?
Brunt Toast knew Jules was doing it. G-Man pen and paper calculator ready to read super chats. I love that you did that in a video. I will found the clip.
Yeah, I hope you found the clip there, Nick. Thank you so much for the $5. It's really nice of you. Thank you for the support. Thumbs up. Horns in chat.
Horns in chat.
Mm-hmm.
That deals with these particular atheists. That is good. That's really good at showing these people poor thinking patterns.
You just said implementing instead of implicating. So poor thinking patterns is not good for you, bro. Like, you did the Rolodex and you were wrong.
You should have just went with activate. We're activating G-Man.
Activate grammar skills. Boom. 404.
Go gadget Grammarly.
That's something like that, but I am one of the people on here who is good enough to deal with them and deal with.
You're not good at dealing with anyone, not even your own kid.
Properly and thoroughly.
You're not good at dealing with anyone properly and thoroughly.
You ain't got nothing to do.
Oh, except for Veckel. And when I said deal with, I mean like
to completion.
Yeah, blow.
Go get some Ovaltine. Go get some.
What the fuck is Ovaltine?
This is proof this fucker is stuck in the 90s or 80s or some shit, man. Like,
get yourself a slim what? Fast.
I'm gonna go have some Butterfinger BBs after this, perhaps. I don't know.
Oh,
maybe
those
some
are
Dunkaroos.
Actually good, though. Now I miss them.
Yeah, I know, right? I'm gonna have maybe a 3D Dorito. I don't know.
I never had those. Were they good?
Yeah, pretty decent.
Do you know what's actually really good these days? Have you had the Butterfinger like Reese cup thing?
I haven't. That sounds fucking amazing.
It
though.
Is really good. I recommend it.
Oh shit!
Stop at your local Wawa.
Yeah. Arizona, like I got right here. I got me a mango Arizona. I got a peanut butter and jelly sandwich in my hand.
So you have a whole $2 in your hand.
No rice though, huh?
PBJR.
Must have not had a vessel to cook the rice.
I don't have a vessel. So I'm eating fucking goddamn, what's that? What is that shit? Ramen noodles a la carte.
Ramen. He gets so upset having to explain it every time. That's why it tickles me.
I want to be violated in my asshole. Sure.
Helen Keller maybe. Pronounced words better than G-Man.
Fuck you, Tito, you goddamn bitch. God, I like Tito.
On my nose. My goodness.
Water.
Rip Butterfinger BBs.
Oh, dude, it is a rip, dude. I like mm-hmm. Butterfingers. Butterfingers are probably one of my favorite candies. Up there with Whatchamacallits. Whatchamacallits are fucking slamming.
Still never had one of those.
They're so good, dude. I recommend them so hard. I would have sent you one for your birthday, but you forgot mine. So I'm not...
Wait a minute. I didn't know that was Frank and Anna and all these people who were super chatting last show. That was on them. Mm. I didn't remember. I didn't forget.
Everyone in the chat also forgot my birthday, motherfuckers.
It's a gray area.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
I got me some egg whites that I'm going to eat when the show is over. I got some pasta okay. that I'll be eating tomorrow morning, and then I'm going to be doing some running tomorrow. So we're just going to take a look at this stream.
Oh, by the way, you don't want to carb load right before running. You want to do that like a few hours earlier. Just like so generally the night before.
They're looking at my show yesterday.
Just now, let him do it, Billy.
Again, we are talking about Burnt Toast. Burnt Toast is a reaction.
But apparently someone mentioned last night there might be a video of G-Man like loosing toenails and shit while practicing for fucking...
What the fuck?
This fucking jog that he does? Fuck, I want to see that.
Bro, you're practicing so hard your toenails are falling off and you're still getting, like,
terrible
elderly
scores.
Women scores?
Terrible scores.
Wow, like, you're really having to push it to get nothing, huh? You suck. You should stop doing that.
Until Burnt Toast thoroughly deals with this topic. A simple, I don't care what G-Man thinks, ain't going to work with me. Well, that's nor is it going to work with the rest of
you. It doesn't matter if it works with you. It matters if it works with her. So she says, I don't care what G-Man thinks, and you saying, that does not work with me. Well, I like to point you to the previous statement of, I don't give a fuck what G-Man thinks.
We're at an impasse here, Gary.
We're not. We're just at the regular pass.
No, we just got to get him to understand.
Oh, my God. I figured out something I need to do. So I need to get into Photo Editor. Fuck it later. Because I need to take that or and the green screen where Gary is right there and Photoshop that same picture that I have behind me onto that green screen and then keep it going. So it's just the same picture all the way down. I'm gonna do that.
Gareception.
Gare Lamontception.
Because now I'm not.
We don't need any more of that.
See, Vecco came on my channel last night. He was like, I came here really to talk to Burnt Toast. I want to know if she knows what the gospel is. See, the more I talk about this, the more Christians are going to get wind of it. And the more
it's just Vecco. No one takes him seriously. Vecco needs a person like you, G-Man, so he doesn't look as fucking stupid as he actually is. You're like a lightning rod for dumb.
So basically, G-Man's the fat chick that the hot girls hang out with?
Yeah, he 100% is.
So they just look better via comparison?
Yeah, and G-Man thinks he's doing like, oh, brother, blah, blah, like doing that shit, but he's actually just a fucking stooge.
You think you're cool.
You goddamn Phoebe.
You think people like you, Gary. That's funny.
He's a Christian. Let me go check out her channel. And then they're going to go over there and be like, G-Man, I don't think this woman's a Christian. They can take one look at what you do.
She's a Christian without a Christian channel. She doesn't live on here, you fucking idiot.
I'm going to do the same thing to prove my point. And she'll say she don't care what pastors got to say. If she doesn't care what I think, she doesn't care what the church thinks.
I want to be violated in my asshole. Sure.
G-Man learned English from Jodie Foster's character in the movie Nell.
Oh, no.
Well, thanks for breaking, Bran.
Fuck. That movie just came on the other day.
Shit off. Why did you show your dick when I asked you to? Because that's what you just told the panel that you showed your dick because I asked you to.
Happy birthday, Billy. Please donate this to the Anna Duke Internet Bill Fund School for Billies who can't read good. Gary is a horrible person. Hashtag VEKL.
Thank you, Mo. I hope you don't get hit in traffic.
I wouldn't want you to pull a Gary.
She doesn't care about what pastors think. This woman ain't a follower of Christ. Because then she don't care about what Jesus has to say about these things. And that's vitally important because now...
Gary, if Jesus disagreed with you, you would put him backstage or mute him. Let's be real. Fuck out of here with that shit.
He would.
Whoa.
Where's your precepts?
By the end of the debate, he'd be calling Jesus an atheist. That'd be great shit.
God, that'd be great.
A Christian's a follower of Christ. Well, aren't you supposed to do what he says? The atheist is going to say yes. She isn't doing what Jesus said.
Well, you could definitely do that with Jesus with when it came to like economic policies and shit like that. Especially because like that fucking goddamn fucking conversation you're supposed to have with fucking Vonster about communism or whatever the neither of these motherfuckers know what communism is. It's fucking terrible.
They have no idea.
What is communism?
Absolutely no idea.
Something that scares me. Well, that doesn't answer the question.
It's whenever the government comes and takes your kids. That's what communism is. They take away Jerry's check.
Jerry's money.
How do you deal with that?
Comrade, this is not Jerry's money. Our money.
It's our money now.
For their reputation at this point, especially when they tell you that they used to be Christians. But anyway, let's take a look at this stream here.
On my nose. My goodness gracious. My goodness gracious.
When G-Man says church, he's talking about himself. He once said forgive the church to Merz Parker when he was wrong about something. I have the clip, G-Man.
Ooh.
The arbiter of Christianity has spoken.
And like I said, from time to time, I'm going to stop.
Oh, and G-Man, before you ask, no, we're not talking about the people that cut down trees.
I'm going to respond to some of this stuff.
Those are arborers.
Some of the things that I said on my show yesterday, you're going to see come to life. You'll understand why I say the things that I say on here. Okay? And then I'll clarify a few things, too. Before I do, let me...
If you were wondering if he is in his He-Man picture, you're right.
Make a public apology to somebody here on YouTube. Yesterday, I had somebody on my channel called Odd Talk New Jersey, I think. NJ. Odd Talk
NJ. You know exactly who that is.
And you know exactly what... I really hope you know what NJ stands for. That'd be really embarrassing if you didn't.
Come to...
Now, I am not a fan of her. I don't agree with... I don't know all of her worldview, so I can't say all of it. But I don't agree with how our interactions have gone with, particularly when we was in the geek room.
Yeah, where you admitted to loving Bukkake. It didn't go well for you. I admit.
It didn't, no.
The reason why I'm being careful with what I got to say, because I'm planning on doing something here. I want to apologize for jumping down her throat too early. I should have took the time out to listen to her first.
You don't have the ability to comb people along. You don't have that ability to milk people to get them to like interview style. You don't, unless they agree with you on basically everything. And without that, you can't do it.
Yeah, there's a reason you didn't do it, Gary. You need to possess the ability first.
Yeah, that's step one.
Shutting the fuck up is a big step toward that goal.
Ooh, it's a massive step.
And then came out and said the things that I was going to say. And I believe between her and Ms. Parker, because I got something to say to her too, she seemed to be the most genuine. Either that or she's a phenomenal actress. But she seemed to be the most genuous in the sense.
The most genuous, huh? That's nice.
That's not what that word means.
How so, Gary?
Why'd you show your dick when I asked you to? Because that's what you just told the panel. That I showed your dick because I asked you to.
Of course, Gary has no idea what an arbiter is. All the cars that he's been hit by were fuel injected.
Fuck you, Wilson.
Genuine, I'm sorry. The most genuine in wanting to have a real conversation.
At least he caught that one.
Ms. Parker, however, whether or not she was acting or not, whether or not she was being sincere or real, she didn't really want a great debate or whatever. She wanted to talk about comics. So I'll humor.
And she definitely wanted to talk comics with you.
Why did you show your dick when I asked you to? Because that's what you just told the panel, that you showed your dick because I asked you to.
Vacation all G-Man ever wanted. He burnt down churches. Anna's not her today. Vacation Gary Lamont Moore should be in jail. Gary failed 8th grade.
Vacation all G-Man ever wanted. He burnt the churches and is not here today. Vacation Gary Lamont Moore should be in jail. Gary failed the 8th grade.
There you go.
You're welcome. I put it to the
get everyone up to speed here.
For her, with some of the requests that she made about her YouTube channel. But again, Ms. Parker is not somebody I trust. As a lot of you say, that has to be earned. All right. So anyway,
what do you mean, as we say?
That's like a normal saying. That's what everyone says. That's like a bag of fucking all that and a bag of chips. Like, that's the same thing everyone
wings,
says.
My
no,
God.
No, 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 it's not buffalo wings. I don't know where he's getting that from. I have no clue where he's getting that from.
Let's take a look at this stream here. We're going to take a look at this Hannibal Monty stuff here.
One of the sayings was featured in the movie Austin Powers, and the other one was an idiot saying bag of buffalo wings.
Every now and then I'll take a peek at this live chat, but right now I'm not looking at it. So
he will not look at it. He gets real mad.
I want to say this too. I will not be granting Burnt Toast the opportunity to come in the room, nor will I grant Monty the opportunity.
It's not an opportunity. You have 492 subs and you had 191 views.
He basically just said, all right, I'm going to do this, but I'm going to be a little bitch about it.
That too. Just also did
any counter narrative, I don't want to hear it.
All that in a bag of buffalo chips. There you go, David. Oh, yeah, chips are really good. I do like them.
Yeah.
My favorite chips are probably Red Hots. Those things are fucking dumb.
Oh, yeah, they are good.
The only problem is, like, it's just like, apparently I'm a family when I eat those. Because it's like, this bag isn't getting sealed, okay?
When I do a stream and I give you the link to come in the room so that you can clear the air about some stuff, take advantage of it.
No, don't take advantage of it, because he's just going to end up blocking. He's a little bitch. Just do something like we're doing where we snipe him. Don't actually go in there. It's not worth it. He's a fucking idiot, and he's a bitch. And he will put you backstage a lot if you make any good points. So if Rick Zilla, it's a good advantage for you, because you're not going to make any good points.
If you choose to waste my time and make me believe that I'm dealing with a troll, then guess what?
Well, thank you for being a member. What was that? Lady Starfire. It didn't give a message for your 18 months, so if you want to type that out, I would totally read it. Just tag
there's going to be some echo in this video, guys. I apologize about that. Nothing I can do about it. Bear with it.
Being good at streaming is something you can do about it.
Right? As I don't feel like going back and forth to unmuting myself on StreamYard. And I just don't.
Oh, man. It's not like laziness is frowned upon in the Bible.
I don't know how to do that. So let's
absolutely
get
not.
Dude, look at that computer struggle.
I can't see it. What are you talking about?
Oh, yeah, you can't see it.
No interest. None of that shit.
Okay, so now he's actually playing something.
Pull up the G-Man stream. Let me send Toast the link first. We're early. No intros, none of that shit. Ain't nobody got time for that shit.
But here we go.
Send in Toast the link.
One second. Pull this over so we can still see our chat. Alright, put that beep, and then beep, and then
on my nose right now.
My goodness gracious.
Got it.
Goodness gracious.
And what, wow, and hold on a minute, pray away though.
Thank you. That I feel like that's just a payback for me for all the times I've done that to drag.
Do we even have to watch the video anymore? You just pretty much said everything Gary was going to say there. So
pretty much. Thank you. Lady Starfire tagged me. G-Man, no one wants you to grant anything. You're not that important. Thank you so much for being a member for 18 months. That is fucking insane.
That's crazy. Thanks, though.
Let's see.
Hippo Crips. Was it Burnt Toast who put a fucking blue bandana around a hippo's mouth? Because that was great.
A hippo grip, yep. G-Man is live right now. Okay, give me 1 second. I'll bring it up.
Oh, shit, is he?
We'll snipe him. We'll do it last time.
There's like, sometimes I hope, you know, maybe he's crying about us. But it could be you. I mean, you live in that fucking dome of his rent-free.
I do. That's because I'm always in a jack home, a little man.
You. Just got it. Let me deal with my darling audience here. Let me get some shout outs to the people that
he got a Napoleon complex or something. Here.
We got JR here. We got dropping videos here. We got Carrie here. We got Pluto Dog here. We got.
Oh my God. So if you're in his chat, let him know that we're live. And sniping him so they don't have to be in his chat.
We got Angry Roach. Yeah. Wait a minute, I think Angry
How to Save a Life.
That name's gonna sound familiar.
Or at least a few hours.
The Reverend Dr. Mark E. Oh, brother.
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 Okay, so
what you gonna do, Gary?
I think he does have a crush on me, Lady Starfire. I'm not a big fan of that.
Another one I need to come after. Then we got
Wait, Gary's got an impression of you.
You got some videos coming your way.
No, he's crush on me.
Then we got Lloyd. Well,
maybe he
here,
wants to.
Who says at least G-Man took the time to Google this? He usually gets his legal advice. Where is it? From the.
Let's see what to say. Well, fuck. At least G-Man took the time to Google this. He usually gets his legal advice from the unicorn that lives under his kitchen sink.
Unicorn that lives under the kitchen sink. There's no such thing as unicorn, sir, unless you're talking about
Right. Oh, have you not read the Bible there? Okay, so Gary, come on. Here?
We got Sailor Mac. We got Sailor Mac. We got Redishin. Y'all need to learn how to spell your names properly.
Wah, wah. Yeah. It's not that they need. It's not that you need to learn how to read. It's they need to learn how to spell their own fucking name. That's right. G-Man wins again.
You need you to learn adults. To spell Tatted, because that spells dated.
Nah, you just don't know how to spell your name.
Fucking idiot.
Because a red Sheehan Chevette. Whatever the heck that is.
You trying to say sorbet?
Somebody says Ice Cube. Like,
what are you? Oh. He's having so much trouble with Red Shot's name here.
Ice Cube, check yourself.
You better check yourself before you wreck yourself. Oh, say the rest of it.
Is it the last part? The my N-word?
Is that an idiot?
Let me look real quick just to make sure.
Weak sauce with me. So anyway, Gentleman Pioneer was the one who recorded me.
We don't care. You're still, like, no matter who recorded who, you still are the douchebag there.
And I have a copy of the conversation.
You're a terrible friend.
I'm glad I do got it. And I will say this again. I have a copy of the conversation. I'll say it again, just so I can get incriminated.
Okay, Gary, I'll say it. I'll say the next part after check yourself before you wreck yourself. You ready? Chickadee, check yourself before you wreck yourself. That's the next line.
Oh, okay.
Or, I have a copy of the conversation.
I don't know what's so upsetting about that, Gary.
I have a copy of the conversation. I have a copy of the conversation. I have a copy of the conversation. Remember, this is GP we're talking about here, okay? So I have a copy of the conversation. I have a copy of the conversation.
I'm starting to think you might have the copy of that conversation there, Bran.
Why are you disgraced from the
Armenian
community? Where's your wife?
Where's your wife? Why are you where's disgraced from the Armenian community? By the way, we don't support the other person in that situation either. It's just two idiots, and it's great. They're both dumpster fires.
Ugh. No wonder they've kind of been drawn to one another here recently. Got it.
Goodness gracious.
Gary Lamont Moore can't read hashtag your fault. Hashtag remedial.
Hey, Drag, the Skype count with recording people, because the last time I checked, dude, you played several recordings of people on YouTube and played it on there, and you made money doing it.
It depends on the state.
Yeah, like what are there? Is it a one party, two party? Like, what do you know about this, Gary? You're just running off at the mouth.
And also on top of that, you guys both are under the same fucking goddamn opinion of yes, you're both recording each other at the same time. And even then on Skype, when you record, it lets some of the other party know. You would know that because you recorded our conversation.
Why do you show your dick when I asked you to?
And I put it on YouTube because it let me download it.
You showed your dick because I asked you to.
Check yourself before you wreck yourself, because big dicks in yo ass is bad for your health.
That's not what your mom said.
I don't know.
On my nose.
I didn't gather that when I saw Rev's first asshole shot.
This fucking idiot thinks I am a therapist.
Well, scary.
You can give him some therapy he wants from you.
Yeah.
It's your wiener.
I forgot about all of the
don't let him pray it
things
away.
That you've been doing on here for like the last 5 years. Track, listen to me, dude. You are the gift that keeps on giving. You helped me laugh today.
No, that's
man.
Your UTI.
Do me a favor, send me your Cash App so I can send you a dollar, man, so that you can go buy some of that
all you got.
Bisque that you claim is so good that it's absolutely disgusting.
Okay, who the fuck is buying lobster bisque for a dollar? Don't eat that lobster bisque.
No, he got mad because he got his lobster bisque from fucking Red Lobster. And it was like, this shit's gross. And they're like, it's Red Lobster. Shit.
Like, what did you expect?
That's like thinking every burger is exactly the same type of burger you get from McDonald's. What kind of fucking bullshit is this?
They microwaved it, my guy. It's, of course it's not good. Stop.
He definitely thinks fucking Red Lobster's fancy.
I will gladly donate to you. Okay?
The only thing Red Lobster has that is fucking banging and slaps is those cheesy bread rolls.
Oh, fuck yeah. But I can make those now, so I don't even need them anymore.
Yeah, but those things slap harder than Frank does to his wife.
Which is why Frank couldn't be with us.
Which is boom, that's a pullback, man. Goddamn.
Atlee donate to you, dude.
And Frank's a southpaw, right? Too. You don't see that shit
I'm
coming.
I'm glad you activated your legal advice mode or whatever. Or
activated it.
Legal advice mode.
Yeah, you don't put a lawyer, you don't own retainer. No, you just activate legal advice mode. That's what you do.
Oh my god, this dude thinks that the world is like Saiyans. God damn it.
Yeah.
He taught me so much today, man. Like I totally didn't know about Pennsylvania whatsoever. The only problem is you don't know where I made my phone calls. You don't know where.
Okay, god, so where'd you make them then? Do you have a case? You don't.
He said Pennsylvania and Jersey are under the same laws, and you really do rarely go into other states. So it's just a safe fucking bet.
Well, that's why he left it ambiguous. If he had something, he would come out and say it.
Yeah, if he was like Gary in a state wait. Where one party recording was legal, he would just say it. He would say, I was in Delaware or New York or Vermont, one of those states up there.
This is going to be a lot more difficult, but this dude is making my life very easy. Yo, on the real,
is he paying your taxes for you?
The winter of G-Man. Somebody if you guys are to. This stupid, give me the fall of G-Man and give me the winter of G-Man, please. I need the fall and winter of G-Man so I can laugh my butt off. I haven't laughed
wait,
this hard
I thought the winter while. Of G-Man was whenever you were walking outside in a blizzard.
It was and sub-zero I did laugh winds.
Pretty fucking hard. I'm not going to lie, Gary. So maybe you have a point.
You know what I mean? So, Drag, tell me how getting on feels, dude, because you will never, ever in your entire life, dude, on an intellectual level, own my behind, buddy. I'm full of surprise.
Own his behind?
Well, he's trying to own your brain, but he clearly lives in there rent-free, so all right.
How do you go about owning G-Man's behind? You just sneak up on him during the prayer?
I don't think you have to sneak.
Just go kee 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 on the way up.
Yeah, and then he's like, what? It does the rev position, and then you're good.
You'd be surprised what I can do, my friend.
You'd be surprised how much this will stretch. Come here.
Don't mention the height of the camera.
Oh, we got the Dragon King here. Do you really think Drag is a therapist? I never said he was a therapist. He did say he works in mental health, though.
You did, didn't you?
He works on his mental health. He does...
Oh,
my goodness gracious.
Gary was banned from PayPal for selling Metro cards.
He was.
Wait, this is real?
That's real.
That's a real thing?
That's a real thing. He got banned on PayPal because he was buying Metro cards and then selling them for an upcharge on PayPal. Or eBay.
Good job, Gary. As Jesus would do.
As Jesus would do. Charge tourists more money for a thing.
Yeah, Jesus hated immigrants and tourists and all that shit.
Unless he's a liar, too. He said he worked. He said, right on.
He did not say he worked in mental health. He says he works on his mental health.
Yeah.
On my channel,
he graduated like Shanny.
I don't think mental health people are allowed to make fun.
My goodness gracious.
G-Man, I will give you clips. I'll do this by working two jobs. And dating my girl by the way she thinks you fake. I keep her off my channel.
People off of work who suffer from mental health thingies and whatnot. That would be anybody that suffers from it. This is why people on YouTube don't concern me, because unless you guys know about me and the people that's listening to you guys, the better. So that way you guys don't know if you're incriminating yourself.
I think I know a little too much. We all know a little too much about you, Gary.
G-Man,
we know how many cars you've been hit by. That's too much.
You're talking about the comment I made when I was in Scrubs. The mental patient I was referring to was him. He didn't realize I was making fun of him. Thank you, Drake. Also, like, they someone already found your rental listing, by the way, G-Man, for the fucking house in Scranton that you won $1,500 a month to rent out. God damn, does it look terrifying.
Ooh. Only $1,500 a month for the house with like most of its roof? Just try to keep me out of there.
Dude, it's bad. Like, one room, like, dude, he didn't fucking, he was like, I don't want it looking too nice. Okay, I don't want to sweep up the whole, like, there's just, like, trash next to radiators and shit. For some reason, walls are purple. Don't understand that. There's only one nice room in that whole entire house, and that's that pool table room.
Which is why I streamed from there.
Yeah, that's why I streamed from there, yeah. I think, like, if you got rid of that pool table, it's probably, like, $200 a month to rent it. And that pool table's doing some heavy lifting.
Hey, Vaughn can afford it.
Yeah.
Did I ever think this dude was a threat? I don't know, but drag that dude. Let's take this beating like a man, dude. Let's take this beating like a man.
Mm.
Take this beating like a man.
Like a man.
Now you're a male.
Thank you, Kimmy Kim, for being a member for 6 months. I love brain cells. I lose brain cells whenever I listen to G-Man. At this rate, I'll be brain dead by Halloween. On the bright side, you'll enjoy the thing. You enjoy the thing you made. And then you
may start enjoying his content unironically. Who knows? Give it time.
We'll I think see. Brett Favre really likes his content from all those concussions and stealing money.
Yeah, from the G-Man.
A famous Vikings quarterback.
Yeah.
All right. Maybe
who desperately needed welfare.
Yeah, yeah. Famously played for the Vikings.
Come up with something. Right. So anyway, guys.
Or the Jets.
I feel like we should make like a Jordan Wizards comment at this point.
My goodness gracious.
Take this beating like a Zachary.
Get the fuck out. Get out. Nope. Nope. Not laughing at that. Nope. Nope.
Oh. This is Ali Dean.
God damn it. Why'd you give me $20? Frank, please change that one. That's too just long.
Covered. It just covers your favorite,
my
though.
My favorite. It's too long. That was annoying.
Is covered. Is my favorite. Being jizz covered is my favorite. My favorite. Being jizz covered is my favorite. Thank you, Billy's beard.
Imagine your life revolving around YouTube and being so awful at it. Hey Rev, I know you're watching. How many veggies would you make disappear for this $20?
His asshole is a farm. Just
no, technically, I think it's a compost if the way you put it that way.
Until next time, the same bat channel, same bat time, same bat channel on the Sowing and Reaping YouTube channel, because clearly Drag got what he deserves on this one for making that statement on his channel. What? You know, you gotta love Drag. Drag's full of all kinds of stupidity. All kinds of stupidity. Oh my goodness.
Wait. What happened?
He thought he owned Drag enough for that video.
Yeah, you got him. Nah, you gotta make him baa like a sheep or something, my guy. That's when you really hit hard.
Yeah, you hit the dislike. Don't worry about it, there, Gary.
Oh,
go.
Scent.
There we go.
By the way, it wasn't Monty's stream where he's moving one.
There's absolutely nothing I can do about the echo.
Yeah, there is. It's called muting.
Absolutely nothing I can do about the echo. I'm sorry.
Pay for an internet connection.
I'm not going back and forth. I'm not going back and forth to unmute myself on StreamYard. So you're going to have to deal with the echo for this. I'm sorry.
There's nothing I can do except for here's a solution of something I can do. I'm just too lazy to do it.
Gary, you know, like, you already have an issue with people sniping you and them getting more views than you do. Maybe you should, like, work on some of these things. You know, to get Jesus' message out.
There's nothing I can do about it.
Sent to toast. Subject for Joe.
My goodness gracious. My goodness gracious.
Gary hit a puppy on camera to disprove slavery.
I remember that. Yeah. He's a fucking idiot.
How does that disprove slavery?
He thought he would win hearts and minds by doing that, apparently.
How does that disprove slavery?
It doesn't.
Okay.
He was trying to make the whole claim about him owning the dog and how that should be wrong, too. Yeah, he's a fuckwit.
This bitch is live right now. And what is my phone? What's happening on my phone? Shit. Yeah, I just sent it, Toast. Just sent it. There you go.
Yeah, hey. I just got your email. Sorry about that.
Gotcha. No, it's okay. It's okay. Yeah, I was just trying to figure out what was up.
Now, the first thing that I want to say, and by the way, if I'm sounding like I'm chewing food, I am.
If I sound like I'm unprofessional, I am.
God damn it. Has he ever tried at anything ever? Parenting, relationship. What you got?
Does UTIs count?
Yeah, but does he try to get those, or is it just because he's too lazy to wash his dick? You know?
Oh fuck, I mean, it's Midwest motherfucking Maverick. How you doing, brother?
What's up? How goes it?
How you doing?
Let me get my shit straight.
Do that.
All right.
Nexus has had a long time. He still hasn't gotten his straight.
Ha ha. What's popping, y'all?
Thank you for letting me use your song in that last video. That was very nice.
Oh, yeah, that was awesome. That was a nice little surprise. I didn't even know.
It was a nice touch added to the video.
Yeah.
I got some new shit coming out, too.
Do you?
Yeah. It's gonna be, just watch... Miss Parker tomorrow.
Nice.
The first thing that I want to say is, you see how Burnt Toast came on Monty's channel to talk about me. Burnt Toast didn't want to be in the same room with me.
Nobody wants to be in the same room with you.
Including Shannon Ref.
When you know somebody doesn't know what they're talking about and when you got them on the run.
And
that's sign
kid.
Number one.
My phone. I just click live and let me turn my ringer off so it...
He is so upset.
We're about to pull it up.
Yes.
Okay, so
he's mad about that part.
He's mad you that know. Someone said that he's mad.
You're gonna laugh about me being upset over nothing. Laugh.
A little as a matter of fact, let's come out of this because this is gonna take a little bit of time to explain. I don't want no echo on this.
I thought you said you didn't care.
Toast, right? Now remember, Burnt Toast is a reaction atheist, all right? She's also a YouTube troll.
Is Burnt Toast even an atheist?
No.
I don't
think she is.
No.
No.
This mother. If G-Man don't like you, you immediately become a staunch militant atheist. You'd be out there burning Qurans and shit on the weekends.
Right. Yeah, we already had the discussion saying that if he got an argument with Jesus on StreamYard, he would call him an atheist too.
He'd be like, he'd probably try to dox him.
He lives in heaven.
Come to heaven
city.
Go to heaven city.
So if I don't be angry, if I'm not,
well, there can't be a jersey there, because if it was, it wouldn't be heaven.
Okay, listen to what he says coming up. Okay, this shit really, this makes me laugh. Okay,
Roberto's is a reaction atheist, all right? She's also a YouTube troll. Trolls are here to make you angry. So if I don't be angry,
If I don't be angry.
He's got it all figured out.
If I don't get angry.
If I don't be angry, I'd be happy.
That sounds like some shit Frank said on the show last week.
It does.
Yo.
Something, something, what vegetables
and
is.
Let me point something out real quick, though. I don't think that qualifies as code switching. For
no.
All y'all that's going to be pedantic.
It's just fetal alcohol syndrome.
Yeah, that just, that's just, because there's some things that he says that fall into that category, but there's some shit
that ain't one of them.
Just,
If I'm not angry, she's not doing her job. And the rest of the trolls that watch her won't financially support her anymore. Because
so why do you keep getting angry
to get under your skin and to get you to behave in a certain manner? I can assure you.
Why does he have Paulo Gia's head on a bike? what the fuck is that about?
I'll give you two guesses of who this guy is.
Yeah, that's Chef from fucking South Park.
Yeah, pretty much.
Want my salted balls?
Stick them in your mouth.
Oh my God.
You with this. When I did my stream, I was not mad and I was not angry. I personally think
you're still mad.
They lie on purpose to determine whether or not somebody is angry.
Everyone just watches your shit
from other people.
Takes from it what there is.
I honestly and truthfully believe this. If you went to one of these reaction people and said, do you know the difference between joy and happiness? I don't think they know. I don't think they know the difference between sadness and depression.
Oh.
Yeah, there's a massive difference. Sadness is like something happened. Depression is a state of mind.
Yeah.
I don't think they know the difference between anger and passion.
That one's really far off.
Yeah, it's not even close.
Yeah.
Come on, Gary.
I'm passionately angry about that.
Remember what the title of my video was last night. I personally believe that burnt toast is an airhead. There's not a lot going on in her brain. All right? For her to be able to
be happy.
Virginia.
In the windows.
How did he say Vietnamese?
Oh my God, he probably chopped that word to shreds.
He fucked it all up.
I don't remember, but I know it was excellent.
Vietnamese.
Yeah, he was talking to Vaughn,
to know
I think.
What emotion
I think so too.
You're listening to at a given time. There are videos on YouTube that you could compare and contrast with my other videos to know when I'm angry. And I can recommend the videos to you when I'm ripping on Veckel. I'm ripping on some of my old friends. I'm saying, not my old friends, some of my friends.
Non-friends.
When I'm ripping on atheists. When I'm ripping on GP. I got videos. There are videos on YouTube
that exist video.
Where I'm angry.
He's got videos.
And then there are videos where I'm passionate. And again, you have to have an education. And this is a slight.
Thank you for being a member for 5 months there, Wyo girl. Is bleeding from your ears a good or bad thing?
Well, you could be like Gary and piss blood, so I'd say it's better.
Bleeding from your ears is a sign that everything is okay with you because this is some old bullshit.
Slap.
Just another day.
One burnt toast. I do not believe this girl knows
I love
the
how
difference
Billy got up and G-Man was just standing there behind
her. The
what's up, Mandy?
Good at expressing themselves as opposed to a person who's angry. Starting to wonder if she's ever seen an angry black man before.
Oh shit.
She claims that she's
G-Man's gonna show us.
Doesn't know how black people behave when they're angry. I don't
what
think
does that even mean? What the fuck? Oh, what the fuck does that even mean? Dreams,
the entire monolith that is black people act the same way when they're angry.
The four things that black people are to do when
things
they
will come across other people.
In no particular order.
So,
no, there's an order.
You're not going to hear me being angry. You hear me being passionate. You want to hear me angry? Go find a stream when those people went on my property and slashed those tires. That's
nobody did that.
There's a lot of proof on hearing me being angry. I don't think this
basically
young little girl
every fucking
here,
stream
whether
you
she's
do
in her 20s or whatever, I think she is in her 20s, but whether or not this little girl or not is
didn't he say she was hot at some
is,
point?
is educated enough or qualified, really. Let's use that word. Educated.
Well, at least he's not lying, because then he'd be worse than Matt Bell.
People's emotions. If you say right? that about a woman, you know that's a dick. But anyway, let's go back to the video.
Dick?
Because she doesn't know the difference between these things. And I'm sorry about the echo. There's nothing I can do about it.
So dumb. Just,
it sounds like his response to everything negative in his life. There's nothing I can really do about it.
He posted a link because now he's demanding that I join him, which that's not going to happen.
Yeah, see that.
Yeah, that's not going to happen. I've already joined panels in the past.
Yeah,
I think it was like a year ago.
Before she got 1,000 subscribers. Let's continue. We'll get to that in a minute.
Twice and all. Well,
she's had you on her channel since then.
Yeah. There's really no point if he's going to act like that. Besides, last time I was on there, he blocked me and then told me that he was not going to unblock me from StreamYards unless I, quote, showed my body privately to him.
Oh shit, son.
Ah, and you also think she's
a
little
is a creep.
Not really sure I said that. I said that if you have to
whoa.
So we can see what you look like. That's what
I maybe it wasn't exactly like that.
Yeah, it wasn't exactly things
to what I feel like I should be like, G-Man, we have the transcript.
Video respond to this. We'll see what she actually says since the stream exists on my YouTube channel. You know what I mean? But again, she said that she's already joined panels. This is what happens, ladies and gents, when your channel gets a little bit big. Your head start getting big and you start thinking you're better than everybody. Now, I've been
says that the guy who keeps bringing up his main channel.
Blame her for saying that. I have 13K and I won't come on, blah, blah, bullshit. And even then, dude, I think when...
Oh, you
when,
had your headphones on, right, Billy?
Yeah, I heard my headphones.
Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, when he said he wanted to see Burnt Tone's body...
No, and before that, what he said about what black people do when they're angry.
Oh, they have like four different things they can
all
do.
All black people say, like, you really wouldn't like to see us when we're upset.
So all black all people are the Hulk?
Yeah, we're all the Hulk, dude. If you fucking piss me off, my eyes, they turn this color.
Do you turn green or do you just get blacker? Like, how does that
work? Yeah, you get the madder you get, the blacker you get. And there's levels to it. Like you
that
get,
makes
like,
sense first... because fucking goddamn Midwest is one of the most chill dudes I've ever met, and he's light skin as fuck.
Like if I get happy, I lighten up and shit. Like
see, that's where the phrase comes from, lighten up.
Like starlight. Fuck you.
I'm starlight. Like, damn, I'm happy as fuck today.
Where I'm different than a lot of other people here on YouTube. Yes, I'm very open. I'll talk to the average smo out there.
Smo.
Smo. What the fuck is a smo?
I think he wanted like to a say Joe. 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 Oh, I think he wanted to say.
But even a Joe smo.
Like Shmo. That word alone. It's like Joe Schmo or average Joe. Like you don't know. Come
he,
on, Gary.
If he would have just said Schmo, I would have gave it to him.
Yeah.
Literally, I really would have gave it to him, but he didn't even get that.
Trying to get be understanding here, Gary. It's difficult.
Also, Wilson, fuck you for that super chat earlier.
I thank you for that.
I do what I can.
Take the beating like a fuck you.
Yeah, I couldn't get to the mute button in time, so I was like, nope, stop it.
The moment you have me thinking I'm wasting my time. The moment you have me thinking where the moment you have a person like me thinking you're not worth
just
the
when
air,
you think you've got all the answers, I
oh,
change
you ain't
the question.
Worry about getting the invite. I'll just talk about you forever.
So Wilson.
And if I say the wrong
don't
thing, and
throw
you
rocks at a
you.
Man with a machine gun.
What?
I am here to chew bubble gum and kick ass, and I'm
oh,
all
out
of
bubble gum.
Those are all Roddy Piper quotes.
They are. I think you and I were the only one that got where that was
oh,
going.
Oh, I knew it from Duke Nukem.
They Live.
Yeah, Duke Nukem is where I got that from.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
That's true. Okay, so ban Billy and ban Midwest for not having actual like taste.
No, very... at Duke Nukem of like the original, not Duke Nukem Forever. No one played that.
No, this is like Duke Nukem back in the day with the fucking pig cops.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, saying, this isn't very got... rowdy of you guys.
Yeah, they got that quote from Roddy Piper.
Yeah.
Well, All I know is I don't ever watch wrestling because, you know.
I did. I watched it, and then I turned 11.
Okay, so Billy, have you seen? You watch South Park, right, Billy?
Yeah.
Wait, you still watch Dragon Ball, though, don't you?
So, Billy, you know when Jimmy and Timmy, they had the fight in the alleyway?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, shot for shot.
Shot for shot, that was based off of the fight scene between Roddy Piper and Keith David in the movie They Live.
Not this year.
Huh.
Put on the hat.
You should have thought about that before you decided to say you didn't want to talk to me no more. Because I can play that game, too. I ignored Dragon for a whole year.
No, that's not what happened.
That I can ignore people on here.
That is not
what
happened.
Well, that's not the only reason, but you know what I mean.
You make a contract video, and then you tell people that you can't legally talk about that person.
Yeah.
And then you talk about that person, not on YouTube, to, what's that dude that told us that he was burning pictures of drag?
Ken?
Yeah, Ken Jones.
Yeah.
Ken Jones. Yeah, you tell him about that in real life, and then you're burning pictures of him, which is not terrifying.
You could see the life leave Gary's eyes momentarily.
No, you can't talk about that.
Next time, tell us what song he was listening to while he burned them.
She's got big YouTuber-itis or whatever now, right?
Who's Shanny?
You know, I think
she's talking about Burnt Toast.
Burnt Toast is channel size.
No, yeah, Burnt Toast is still a down-to-earth, very down-to-earth person. Like,
right?
Like, I could send Burnt Toast the link right now, and she might come on if she's not doing anything.
Yeah, I think that someone actually did the math. Burnt Toast is only about 1,000 subs away from overtaking the fucking WMD that is G-Man's main channel. Fun fact, one of those channels has not existed for 11 goddamn years.
And isn't filled with dead subs.
Mm.
How about that, Gary?
Has 11,000 subscribers, I think.
He was listening to Raining Men.
Maybe she got more than that. I think she has like 11,000 subscribers.
He is keeping tabs on her subs.
Is that she got big YouTuber itis?
11,000 subs is not a big YouTuber. It's still a small YouTuber. Are you Steve McCray?
He thinks that it's big because he's got that many, and he thinks he's big. So by that logic.
Fuck me running. Like, Miss Parker had more people watching her snipe the fucking non sequitur show.
I know, Mandy. You're right.
Jesus. That's awful.
Let me switch back to Apex. That's what I'm saying.
Please, dude.
Non sequitur went live, and Grampy had more viewers than they did.
That's hilarious when you got more snipers. Sniping you, the actual people watching you.
Dude, are you talking about the Landon Curt Null one, or there's like, it was like, let's talk about science fucking communication with fucking Landon Curt Null and a fucking moron, also known as Steve McCray.
That guy's so smart. He is so smart.
He actually is really smart. It just,
yeah, I know.
It's not interesting.
He's a new SMART
or some shit like that.
It's like he's really, but that's not the type of channel you have. Like, you have a debate channel. So is he debating anyone or just sitting there fucking, you guys are blowing each other?
He looks like a Weeble Wobble.
A little bit, yes.
Will he fall down?
Probably.
Most likely.
Understanding if she compares herself to the Amazing Atheist or Dusty Smith.
She did re-download Apex there.
Who the fuck is talking about TJ or Dusty in 2022?
Does Dusty still do that?
Does he?
Last I heard about Dusty was about 4 years ago, and he became like the super, like damn near racist conservative.
Yeah, because it was the atheism plus days, and he went negative.
He went from one extreme to the other, essentially, last I heard.
Yeah, if I saw Dusty Smith like running down the street on fire, I wouldn't piss on him.
He just wants to be a contrarian. Smith? Yeah, he just wants to be the contrarian.
That dude went to fucking white. He looked like fucking Drew Carey now and shit.
Hell yeah, he did, didn't he?
He went white fast, like he saw a ghost or something.
Yeah. Same one Shanny saw.
Somebody in this thing here has got a lot of them. I mean, even Nate the Lawyer is puny compared to, like, the Amazing Atheist. He has a million subscribers.
Not a million. That's because the amazing atheist represents all of us. Atheist
speaks for every atheist.
I can almost, without looking at it, I can almost guarantee that Nate probably gets more views in his video than TJ does.
He's got to.
Yeah.
Last I heard, TJ was kind of dropping.
Yeah, the last I heard, I've never actually watched a fucking Amazing Atheist podcast because I don't like the dude. But even like on like when he does Deep Fat Fried, yeah, he might have 200-300 live viewers.
Oh, Dusty's lefty now?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Fucking someone quick peel me off the floor.
Yeah. He's grifting whatever the fuck is hot, wherever he senses he can get the most support. That's what I perceive, because it's you don't make those big of ideological changes that fastly and that often.
Right. Is he basically like a successful version of Brett Keane?
I mean, more anything's more successful than Brett Keane.
But same
to be
style.
Fair, TJ is the exact same way.
Oh my God.
I remember during the Trump election that, you know, TJ and Dusty and like they were sidling up next to fucking Sargon of Akkad. Like, right. Oh, SJWs are they're gonna bring down this country and we need to fucking deplatform them.
Wolverine's fat little brother.
Yeah. Yeah, you got a point, Wilson. I mean, they're cut from the same cloth for sure.
Subscribers. Nate the lawyer, I believe, has 100,000, if I'm not mistaken.
Over. So
if you compare the two, they're not that, you know, the Amazing Atheist has been on here longer and has been doing this at a certain pace or whatever, and he has a bigger channel or whatever. But
see, G-Man doesn't understand stats. He looks, he's the kind of guy that looks at like what you did at one point. He's like Al Bundy. He scored those 4 touchdowns in that one game in high school.
Yeah. Yeah. Full guy.
Fucking Uncle Rico over here.
4 touchdowns.
Yeah, but so like with my conversation that G-Man recorded on Skype that I downloaded because Skype tells you, you can tell the point where he hung up on me is when he was comparing his subs versus our subs, and I said, okay, let me go look at views though. Let's look at our views versus your views, and click, hung up on me.
Yeah, the second you bring up any kind of like analytics, G-Man, I think the actual term is he catches a bit of the hush mouth.
Yeah.
Drag makes him do that a lot too. Like Drag will say something and I forgot what he asked him, but Drag asked him some shit the last like 6 months ago. He was like on his live stream and he asked him something and then Drag started going, yeah, what? You ain't saying nothing now, are you? Shut the fuck up, bitch. Yeah.
Oh, when Drag played that clip from the Tom Rabbit stream from a while ago when G-Man and Nate, like, they had their face off one-on-one, and Nate had to remind him, like, hey, I'm from Harlem, New York. I can code switch like the best of them. And when he said, I gotta start treating G-Man like a fresh bitch.
Oh, I remember that. Yeah, I remember that audio. Because Derek played that a couple times, more than a couple times.
Toast is basically saying at the end of the day, she's self-important. What she wants to be able to do is to go on her YouTube channel and say whatever she wants to say about people without being challenged.
That's have you met all you?
Mirror.
You just described some of your attributes
I said
there,
in previous
Gary.
Videos, when you're dealing with cults and you're dealing with con men and con women, one of the ways that you can know that they're lying to people is when they don't want to be challenged. I went on her YouTube channel.
That's
this rejection
fucking you.
Is so hard right now, dude.
Right, it's wow. Oh,
by the way, folks, I threw out my back. I need donations because I am in the hospital currently. Please donate to what the fuck did Rev say? #. I'm sorry, Wilson on Cash App. I am in dire straits.
You said cash tag?
He did say cash tag.
That ads in money.
I went on here very briefly to confront her about some of the things that she was saying. And in my own personal opinion, I believe by going in there by saying, prove this, why don't you come to me when I've, and this is something that we're going to talk about today. I've physically been in the room or in the house with Shanny and Rev, and I've been around those kids. I see what's going on.
What'd that smell like?
You're a dipshit is the problem.
Ooh,
Miss Parker, if you have a link from a month ago, it's still
you're
the
good.
Same link.
It's always
we haven't changed it.
Every time you link me, it's the same.
It's the same link. I'm just making sure your stoner ass is paying attention.
For at least almost 2 months at this point.
Hey, just read your shirt, and that you'll understand what I am. Right here, I'm making big.
Yeah, that's Billy right there. Me and Billy, that's some Billy Brainchild shit right there.
Me, Billy, and Mandy Brainchild there, or me, Midwest, and Mandy's Brainchild.
Mandy was there too. That's right.
At the bottom line, at the end of the day,
it takes a real man to wear a shirt that says "I'm a little prick."
Billy didn't read that
in her life. All she's doing is receiving.
I still like the cute from the gecko is probably my best, my favorite one. Yeah.
Information and claiming she knows what's going on.
I'm gonna send you a text, Billy.
That threatens her. It threatens her livelihood. So she doesn't want to be in the same room with me because she knows I'm making sense when I say this. Again, would you rather ask the person who claims that they're getting information from somebody, or would you rather talk?
I really hope this is not Yato this time.
I mean, if it was Yato.
Thank God. It's not Yato.
Hey, you know how in the grocery store they'd be like, niggas.
Well, they're really trying to get our fucking white channel canceled.
Every time I come on, someone tricks me into saying something racist. Let me fix my... Hold on. There we go. Now I'm right. There we go.
There we go.
That's better. Now I can be racist with immunity.
Channel struck.
Oh, did you like my background?
Yeah, look. That was so...
Oh, my God. That is a beautiful background.
G-Man. It's G-Man literally flexing in Goodwill shirts.
He's so strong. So
but here's the thing. I think you guys need to give G-Man a bone, okay?
No, that's track
job. That's what G-Man wants is a bone.
You fucking beat me to it.
G-Man has been watching for 20 years now. He finally understands how this works. He's in it. He's opening up the room. He's talking to everybody. He's making reaction videos.
I'm still blocked.
He's doing his thing.
Still blocked.
You're an asshole.
G-Man is a 12-year-old, 50-year-old.
Yes, dude, I get called out every fucking every fucking third stream, and I'm blocked still. God damn it, fuck off, Mo.
I mean, I'm blocked. I can't talk in his chat. I just go to his link. I just click the links and I go in.
No, I'm blocked in StreamYard.
Oh yeah, no, I had to like make a bunch of different. Yeah,
I'm not making another one.
Well, see,
you have the one.
I tried doing that. I've tried making socks on StreamYards. Apparently, I'm blocked on my device.
He blocked your IP address.
IP address blocked you? Like,
he blocked a quadrant of the city to make sure that you can't go to the library and log on.
Who's sorry now, Wilson?
Shanny's going to be able to tell you things about me that Drag will never be able to tell you. Rev's going to be able to tell you things about me that Burnt Toast and the rest of these other people on YouTube will never be able to tell you. You want to know why? They've been around me. They see me happy. They see me sad. And they have seen me angry.
We've seen all of those things.
Yeah. In one stream.
Yeah, it was the one stream with you with Indigo Butterfly.
When Drag was doing his stream today, somebody brought up the fucking Shield Squad video when you were literally crying.
Oh, with his eyes were all fucking...
After he had gotten off the phone with people G-Con and Vocab, where you fucking blew your vocal cords out because you were screaming at them.
Yeah.
And you said you were taking an indefinite break from YouTube, which I believe lasted a whole whopping 48 hours.
And if this avatar doesn't reek of hyper-masculinity, I don't know what does, but anyway.
What? That avatar has the smallest penis.
G-Man.
And the masters of stupidity.
It actually worked out pretty well because you've been using this way longer than BGTV had that fucking thing or that super chat thing, and he just did this on his own. Also, like, I didn't know there was a black key man, but you know, good kudos finding it.
The one head that's up there is that's Paul Ogier.
Paul Ogier. Yeah,
that's
Paul
Ogier.
Yeah, I think the three head.
Paul Ogier, don't do that. That's
Paul Ogier. Paul Ogier. Yeah,
I think the three heads on Pikes are Paul Ogier, Drag, and Arn Raw.
It is, yeah.
And he bragged about like, remember that skeleton thing? I got something special for you. Oh, you mean like some like trivial like what was it, the general insurance company, like, advertisement? Like, yeah.
Congratulations, you got a clip from, like, 2014, and you just had someone fucking Photoshop people inside the fucking pumpkin heads.
Also, on top of that,
the free trial.
I didn't know you could fucking use a fucking flip phone to make images today. Like, what the fuck is up with this picture?
Oh, dude? Yeah. That's why I'm saying you guys have to give him. He is doing his.
No, he's
best,
not any
yo.
Better. He's not doing any but better. Because when he does that short and shit and he's standing, which I can only assume is the sun right against his fucking face, and he's completely washed the fuck out, and you have no clue. Like, he looks like he just got irradiated.
Like nuke the fridge.
Yeah.
Somebody put him in a microwave for 30 seconds.
Someone get this man some right away.
Gremlins.
And know things about me the rest of you don't know. So Burntos, I don't believe that's the reason why you don't want to be in the room. You can simply make demands. You can say, look, if I come in your room, I want to be able to speak without being interrupted.
People have made those demands before. You're a fucking child and no one will come in your room because you will not follow that demand.
Billy, stop Gish Gallop.
Yeah.
Not a Gish Gallop. That was a single.
No, just stop.
That was a concise Gish Gallop.
Yeah.
That was consecutive Gish Galloping, and you're cluster fucking the conversation.
See, now you actually sound a lot like Neg. So you're just gonna say fallacy, and then.
And now you're strawmanning.
Exactly. Why are you moving the goalpost, Billy?
Yeah, you're strawmanning me.
Why are you filibustering the stream?
You filibustering. Listen. At the bottom of the line.
At the end of the day. It's all fine and well.
It's all right, dude. Yo, somebody needs to make a picture of somebody finding a well. Somebody can draw better than I can. Like a guy's like, oh shit, a well.
Have a border collie find G-Man it. Like, what's that, Lassie? Y'all fine and well?
Have G-Man find the well. Like,
I can actually do that. I can actually do that.
Oh, that'd be awesome, dude. I would love that. I'm the idea man.
It's okay, Billy. You can have your stream back now.
Fuck you. Can I? Y'all are pieces.
Signed and well, Billy. Don't worry.
Y'all are pieces.
Okay, so let's have Billy have a stream. Yeah, everyone mute.
Oh, we're meeting?
I actually did philosophical discussions, like, seriously, and y'all are fucking just the worst. I'm sending Burnt Toast the link because she's...
Miss Parker, you're not muted.
Yeah, I think we're supposed to mute, actually.
I'm so muted. I'm muted.
Yeah, I'm glad no one can hear me, especially that piece of shit, Billy.
And if I could give any of you guys cancer...
Yeah.
Billy, we're supposed to be fucking muted. Shut the fuck up. We have...
It's too bad he can't serve in the United States military because he's from Puerto Rico.
Okay. I can't believe this fucking idiot still has
another
muted.
Country?
The Billy has to...
Puerto Rico.
He's illegal. We gotta deport
Billy
him.
Had to hop the wall.
Yeah, y'all are fucking hilarious. I don't hope any of you guys get cancer. Please be Toasty and not Jules. Okay, that's actually Toasty.
Here, I'll be there. Yeah, not a white girl. What's up, Jules?
Oh my God.
Karen Toasty. I love Karen like Toasty. Yeah.
Out to the
Karen
manager.
Toast.
She does love the butter.
My favorite thing is G-Man's now pretending like he knew it was Jules the whole entire time.
Yeah.
but he hit on her thinking, God, like that's what... Anyway.
Do you know what his test for if that was you, Toast? Did you see what his test was?
What?
You Jules calling him a bitch.
Are you serious?
He's like, oh, so this is her.
Only Toast
we all know
call
that's
me
actually...
A bitch.
What's her name? Fucking Lady Ava.
Yeah, he thought Jules was Lady Ava the other day. I was like, we don't sound anything alike. None
of
these
you guys
people
do.
Sound alike.
Y'all just have feminine sounding voices, and that's the end of the list.
My favorite was when Jules was like, yeah, I've had like 20 abortions. And G-Man was like, oh, really?
Oh, yeah, the 20 abortions.
Oh, yeah.
No, because he said, he's like, you should get one so you know they're having some. And she goes, yeah, I had 20.
Well,
what was funny was it was like
20 of those in every month because he doesn't know how.
Hey, you should have told him you got a fucking, you get 12 abortions and you get the 13th one free.
That's the one how we do abortions are.
Yeah, right. like it's a punch card.
It's a punch card. <yeah. laughs>
What are y'all trying? Abortions are us. We're better than coat hangers, folks.
What the fuck?
Exactly. Why are y'all trying to fuck up my goddamn hustle?
Exactly. I was going to say we have that. We come out with the
home. We're really good at really, 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 really late stage abortions. By the way, congratulations on 3 years of streaming there, Grampy.
On my nose. My goodness.
Also, fuck you, Billy. We celebrated your birthday.
What in the what? All that in a bag of buffalo wings.
You literally said at the beginning of that stream when Mistaken Reaper said it's also Billy's birthday. You said no, it's not. It is yours.
It's all fine and well.
It's all fine and well.
You weren't supposed to be watching that. Fuck you, Billy. This is why no one likes you.
Puerto Ricans don't actually have birthdays.
Fucking creepy.
I have no
Everybody
idea when I was
admitted that he was stalking me in my chat. How dare you watch me while I'm streaming in my chat, you creepy fuck.
Right, it's your birthday.
Frankly, I want to know what the entree was if you got a bag of buffalo wings on the side.
What Jeez. The fuck is a bag of buffalo wings?
I know. Like,
also, that seems messy.
Also, like it isn't more Costco important. Or something. Also, Reaper's birthday is more important than mine anyway. He's a better person.
I'm half black, so I know the month I was born in. Definitely
a
better person.
A fat bastard in a bag of buffalo wings, probably. Anyway.
You're fucked.
That's what people do when you want to be respected on people's channels. Because if I went on your channel, let's say you invited me tomorrow and you said, G-Man, I want you to come on. Let's schedule something to have this talk.
Please?
Why would I do that?
Nobody wants to talk to you, buddy.
He's already been on my channel and he raged quit.
He's trying to fill up the hours of the day because he's currently apparently not working.
I love that for him.
Call it a mulligan do-over?
Mm. I might say to you, okay, I'll come on here under one condition. I want to be able to speak for 3 minutes without being interrupted. If you can't,
there's a tackle there for a hug box.
It's
fucking trash. Thank you trash, for being a member for 17 months. Puerto Ricans aren't born. They just crawl out of a mound of monofungal and at the baptism. Thank you, buddy.
Oh, did you just say monofungo?
Monofungo.
It's
like,
mofongo.
I was going to say, is it mofongo? Like, that's the worst accent ever. Like, okay, DC media girl.
Dude, I put that shit straight in my regular language. I put that shit, I didn't put any stank on that. If I put stank on that, that would be DC. Because you heard her say the N-word, because she'd be like, oh, normal, classy, everyday, blah, blah.
Nielga.
She
started with her whole chest. She practiced that in the mirror. I promise you. She was listening to Cardi B and everything. She was ready.
Can you imagine?
She sounded like fucking stank meaner.
Yeah, she was ready.
Like the first
she
two
was like,
minutes
I
of
got
that.
This. She's like, hold my beer, watch this. Yeah. Hold my chums, watch this.
Yeah, I got insurance. Ass whipping insurance.
She's like the Rachel Dolezal to be like Candace Owens.
If Rachel Dolezal and Candace Owens had a baby, it would be an old Jewish woman. Yeah. I love it.
Don't forget Hispanic, because a generation ago, people moved from Europe to
Latin
country, which makes her Hispanic.
She's the Latinas. I forgot. I'm so sorry.
She's Martina Martinez.
Didn't Nez make a fucking joke that fucking DC's family immigrated to Argentina because they were all former Nazis?
Yes.
Are you serious?
Yes.
He laid that shit down. That's why I was dying, cracking up, almost pissed myself when she was like, oh, I'm from Argentina. I was like, no.
And then he claimed to be a victim because of that, too? Yeah. Like, oh, my God. I killed 6 million people.
That's different because now I'm saying that I'm willing to come on the channel, and I'm saying I want to be respected when I come on your channel.
Burntoast, you gonna respect him?
Hell no.
Okay.
Hey, Burntoast, can I come on your channel?
Absolutely.
Fuck
anytime.
Yeah, fuck you, G-Man.
Anyone but Mo from this panel.
This is come on.
Yeah, that's just another thing I can do that G-Man can't.
regarding
real quick though this topic. G-Man did actually he reported on the number of deaths in World War II to be what was it, 2.8 billion people. Do you remember that? Yeah. That was the population of the world at that time.
Yeah,
he called out on it. It was shown to him, and he goes, "That's not where I got my source." I'm like, "Oh, okay."
Yeah. He was debating actual Jake from, I think the channel name is Bible Reloaded.
Yes. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I think they have like 200,000 subs.
Bran, what do you think about him?
I think he's quite the great guest to have on your show. You should bring him on so he could sit on his phone in the background and not say anything or contribute the entire 2 hours and then get mad at someone's political opinion for no reason. Yeah, he contributed a lot.
Who is this?
Actual Jake.
Jake.
Oh.
Sounds peachy.
The funniest thing about that whole debate was that after the debate, when G-Man like fucking rage quit, like he went 100% G-Man. He lost his fucking mind. G-Man did the fucking live stream next to the, you know, fucking like rest stop bathroom at fucking midnight.
So you mean he just got through a night of fun and decided to make a stream about it?
Well, Jake was on, like, he did an after show on his Twitch account, and when he saw that G-Man was live, everyone raided his chat. It is the first fucking time on GTV Network I've ever seen triple-digit numbers when it comes to live viewers. And all they were doing was posting the fucking corn emoji. Because Jake did the fucking debate wearing a goddamn corn hat.
Yeah, I remember that, yeah.
And Jill was fucking blocking people left and right.
Sounds about right for Jill.
Right. I see the momentum that I have against these people regarding this topic. Now, a lot of you atheists are going to...
What fucking momentum?
Yeah, right. He just says
sit here and say,
look at that avatar.
I got no momentum. Drag's been doing this. Listen to me. You can live a fantasy world all you want. But in the world of
evidence or no momentum,
none of them have addressed these serious issues that I'm talking about.
I've never seen somebody describe themselves so often.
Yeah, it seems uncanny valley, yeah.
Right?
He didn't care or whatever. He never gave us a well thought out answer. Except for when he looked visibly upset about something that I said. You understand what I'm saying? You guys need to know something about me, morality.
You need us know something about me, morality.
Me, that's morality is real.
You know what he's done a lot recently? He's been talking in third person recently. Like, I don't know if it was a stream today, because he's done two today. Or if it was the one from last night, but he was like, yeah, and G-Man, blah, blah, blah. And I was like,
"That's
why
worst.
Are you talking in third person?
He does that a lot because he's going back to like his pro wrestling fanhood.
Oh, yeah.
Well, yeah.
He's trying desperately to be the Rock.
He's cutting promos.
He saw some clips from Bob Dole, too. Like Bob Dole this, Bob Dole that. Like he's stuck in the 90s.
Bob Dole.
I vote for Bob Dole.
When we're talking about right and wrong, whether or not somebody's a horrible person, this is a topic that if you come and talk to me about, you better know what you're doing. Because if you don't, you're going
to
look
finger,
silly.
Like,
yeah, I was about to say, it sounds like he's right? poking
a
something.
A lot of people are angry and upset with me because he's of the way tapping. I hold the front toes. Let's just face it, a lot of you don't like me calling her a whore.
Well, I would appreciate it a lot more if you said the word the right way. Burnt toast is not a whore. She's a fucking hoo-ah.
There you go.
Yeah, and it doesn't help that you think she's underage either. Like,
yeah. Anyway.
It's interesting because he'll be like, oh, well, you know what I mean. I mean, view whore. But then he'll say that I have STDs and I'm a prostitute.
Yeah.
And hold up a $5 bill. And I'm just like,
You get chlamydia for watching the stream.
It's almost as if you're caught in a fucking lie, Gary. You're caught in a fucking lie.
This is a show I can't. Nickelodeon.
He's gonna pull a bitch and a fucking pussy, and then it swings around and goes.
I gotta whirl around the fucking shower rod because the cats fucking destroy it.
How's that guy's heart not exploded?
I don't know.
I miss that guy.
Yeah, me too. I've actually
done
surviving.
Trying to get people to harass a motorcycle shop, last I heard.
Yeah. Yeah, where he says he's not allowed to call them anymore, but he released their fucking telephone number on YouTube.
Try it again, Mike.
Give me a Glock Nickelodeon, just for fun.
Okay. Name's Glock Glock, there it is.
That's so great, dude.
So fucked up.
At the very end of the last G-Man video that I did, G-Man did the same kind of Nickelodeon sound. You're welcome to take it. And anybody can take it for super chats.
I'm not calling her a physical whore where she goes out there with men and sleeps with men. And what I'm doing with her is
you're not even a physical piece of toast.
Is this like a negs argument? Are you a mental whore?
Apparently.
You're digitized.
She's a meta whore? What the
hell? Digital whore.
Not a
whore, because he doesn't know what those are, but yeah.
She's like a Digimon. It's more like a digi whore. That's what it is.
Totally. See, I was going to go down. I would say she's more like a Tamagotchi. She's like one of those little keychain fucking animals that.
Oh, yeah, to feed them and like.
That you let die after 3 days because you forgot to fucking feed it.
But if you actually buy like a burnt toast Tamagotchi, like it actually charges you money.
Oh, that's fucked up. Yeah. You gotta give her the butter, man.
If you're gonna call burnt toast fat, try to use the hashtag burnt toast is full loaf.
Oh shit.
Thick.
Bars.
Thick as fuck.
In order to actually anything,
she's Texas toast.
In order to get views.
I can't use that as an insult, but who does not love fucking Texas toast? Okay.
For real.
It's too big for my mouth.
Get the fuck out.
That's what G-Man said.
No man said ever.
Right.
G-Man wants something bigger than Texas toast because he can eat an entire like slice of Texas toast in one bite.
Get something cold to drink.
That's what we will call a view whore. A person who wants constant attention on themselves.
That's just you went whore.
You went live twice today, G-Man.
And this,
dude, you live your entire life online.
What a
whore. He's going live like every day now.
And you keep on mentioning burnt toast for one reason only. She has more than triple the people that are in our live chat usually in hers. So that's why you are going at her personally, because you're like, you know what? More attention. You're an attention whore.
Like the only person I can think of off the top of my head that goes live more than G-Man is fucking Cyrax, because Cyrax is a fucking halfwit that he will go live for a minute and a half and realize that his fucking audio is fucked up. He'll end the live stream, but then upload it to YouTube.
There you go. That's how you do it.
Cyrax has like 19 fucking streams on his current channel now, which if it's still there tomorrow, I will be fucking shocked. Yeah. They're like these 45-second videos of his studio sessions because he's a fucking dumbwit.
That's why G-Man is like Dunning-Kruger, because he has more confidence than
Dunning-Kruger.
G-Man.
Oh my god.
That was amazing.
One more time, choir.
No, we're not. No, you only had that once.
Go get him, G-Man.
Can this be a
quiet? Yo. That was a little pity dog.
Yeah.
Do this. I want to do this every time I see you guys.
Once I make my point with burnt toast, I will be able to do the next 20 to 30 to 40 months without responding to her one time. Look at this video there. Look at that
this
video there.
This motherfucker is counting by the 20s and 30s.
Because I'm dealing with
Isn't
who she really
30
is.
30 months, like 2.5 years?
He's not prison and shit.
So let me ask all the people that have been around for like way longer than me. Has G-Man ever been able to do a single stream without mentioning Miss Parker, BGTV, the Geek Room, Drag, me, Jules, some other person that he's beefing with?
He was on the stream with Steve McRae, and he had to choose his words very carefully because Steve is terrified of hearing Drag's name.
He
he has an affinity to bring up what's her name, Bionic Dance, because she was on Tosh.0. I think he's trying to get some popularity there. He brings her up a lot for some
reason. The last time she, like, Bionic Dance spoke to G-Man was on SJ's channel, which, once again, SJ freaks me the fuck out.
She's creepy.
She seems like, her fucking smile and looking into her eyes, I think there's like a pile of like just dead random wild animals underneath her fucking porch.
SJ actually had an audit under academic integrity. So recently,
I remember Jim Majors was fucking dragging her for plagiarizing fucking.
So she probably, the reason she's quiet is probably because that's going on. But anyway, I'm not gonna say anything.
She's very dishonest.
Yeah, she doesn't like me after the whole "there's no atheists in foxholes" thing. I said, first of all, if there's no foxholes anymore, fucking doofus.
So this is nonsense. I'm getting past all of that stuff, and I'm dealing with who she really is. And what she is a comedian.
Thank you.
And in my humble opinion, a joke. But let's continue.
Thanks.
What comedians tell.
Dude, none of your opinions are humble, like, because you're not humble.
I say, the day you have a humble opinion, G-Man. Anyway,
you made your avatar you as He-Man.
That's like going to Monty and be like, "Hey, Monty, you're an artist and you paint."
Got him.
Put your face all connected to your head and shit.
Hi, your name's Brandon, and you should let's go.
You should let's go.
Typically, comedians make a joke.
Are you proud of yourself?
I am proud of myself. What the fuck? Your name's DC Media Girl.
You just now figured that out. I've been sitting here.
I was laughing.
Yeah, this is my DC Media Girl picture. It's a great picture. This isn't a great picture in DC.
It's accurate and correct.
On the way to Indiana.
I got like the cutest little fedora on and everything. What are you talking about? I am adorable.
Billy, play the Six Flags thing.
I don't have it. No, I'm just saying, but like, yeah.
That's too funny.
Like, I've heard G-Man make the comparison.
Look at that Radford, like a third rate t-shirt. Like, what the hell?
Yeah, he found that. For sure.
That's like a high school, middle school t-shirt or something.
Wait a minute. What?
Yeah, it looks like high school.
Is this Jeep that's flying?
It's a university, actually.
Oh, okay.
But he got it from second rate.
It looks stretched out too.
It's bad. It's really bad.
What I said. He's literally flexing in a Goodwill t-shirt.
This is the face that he makes whenever he
wheels. Yeah, this looks
This is the expression that G-Man makes whenever he can go take a pee and it doesn't feel like razor blades.
It's kind of look fiery behind him though. And there's smoke coming up too.
How does he always get them though? Like, where is he putting his dick? That he's not getting UTIs all the time.
Sockets.
He's putting them somewhere. He's putting it somewhere.
He's doing naked push-ups over glass.
Question is where he's not putting his penis. He's not putting it in water. That's the problem.
Because he doesn't want to watch it grow.
He's afraid to take showers because he thinks the steam contains chlorine.
If you clean your dick, that's pretty gay, I guess, or whatever.
I can't touch my penis.
No, that's if you clean your ass, then you're gay.
Then you're gay. Yeah, you can't open up your butt and clean your ass.
I'm the gayest person on this panel. If you open up your butt,
then you're gay.
Well, he can't wash
his penis. Rev.
G-Man can't wash his penis because that would involve touching it, and that's masturbation.
And that's masturbation. Look at his face.
And
it's
also
like
homosexuality. Because if you're a straight man and you touch your penis, you're also gay.
Yeah. Because you are technically you're given a hand job.
Yeah.
You're touching another penis, so you're gay.
Like, look at his brow. Like,
he looks like he's trying to power fart.
But this is the closest you'll see G-Man to the word pride.
and there's a gas cloud coming out from behind him too. It's fucking perfect.
Also, yeah, it looks like he's taking
that weird thing. Like, what's going on there? What's going on with your wrists?
Who does that with their hands when they flex?
Well, that's
like a 4-year old.
That's
flexing.
His super flex. Exactly. That's the super flex. You ever see your kid when they're child. Like, oh, I'm going to run really fast? That's the move they make when they're about to do something really cool.
He looks like he's about to charge up by pulling his feet back like a bull.
Yeah. It's like, well, I'm really fast.
Kame, stuff and whatnot.
He took the time to like Photoshop all that stuff in the background, but he was just like, can I just get a normal shirt? But no, Radford. Like, what the heck?
No,
like,
this was a stock image. This was a stock image. Like, he found.
Yeah, he didn't do this.
Army image.
Found the background. Yeah.
What are you talking about? Like, he was actually the there.
And then.
This elbow wasn't, though.
Yes, what to say.
Yeah, look at that. Yeah, that's a little cut off.
You making fun of him losing his elbow in this confrontation? Is that what you're making fun of here?
He is a hero, an American hero.
You respect.
He killed Fitty Man.
Fitty Man.
He got his shins blown off.
I'll give you $5 and something cold to drink if you can Photoshop me into this image.
Wasn't this like the original cover of PUBG?
It might be. Maybe. I'm not sure.
I got shot in the butt tops.
You ain't got no.
It's not even dimensionally correct like that. Like the bottom, like look at the Jeep. It looks like something out of a video game. Like,
that's why I brought up PUBG. I think this was like I want to say like this was a stock image for a video game.
It probably is a video game we couldn't afford to play.
It came out in the 90s.
No,
that's where he's stuck.
No, I was gonna. It looks like something from like Mercenaries, if you remember that game.
Nearly 50 years old.
Foods. That's the pose you make when you go potty, right?
That is the pose you make when you go potty. Yes. Right?
I was going to make the joke that that's the face you make when you're having.
That's you. That's burnt toast right there. That little picture of the lady right there. That's you. Like, I can see your little icon. Remember when he called you fat? And that's the fat version of you.
Oh yeah, totally.
Yeah, how do you talk out of your shoulder like that?
That's crazy, right?
I still don't know why he had to make the toast mouth move. Like,
yeah, it's toast.
That was
it's a little
so
extra.
Cool. No, I loved it. I give him extra points for going the extra mile and allowing her mouth to talk. You know,
and he put a spider on my face. I was
which is
so creative.
Yeah,
You got put-owned.
Billy, do you remember, like, it was like 2 years ago, there was a guy who called in as Johnny Cochran's cousin and said that G-Man's head looked like a mug of root beer.
Yeah. Frosty and overflowing onto his gracious face.
Yeah, he's like, can I finish?
I hate the fact that Mo's basically a historian for the fuck shit I've done on this channel.
He's a historian for all the fuck shit, honey.
Sorry.
Yeah. Welcome.
Kind of how it goes.
Oh my God, I didn't know about that.
Yeah, he said that. And that's what began the creative process of making the horror music video.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what gave me the idea for that.
Jesus, okay.
Yeah.
I will say this about Burnt Toast's YouTube channel. I find her to be a lot more entertaining than some of these other reaction people. I said that in past videos. I also...
But yet you're willing to dox her by using some random drunk fucking housewife's video... revealing the image of a fucking.
I didn't make a video.
Not you.
Drunk White Housewife.
Oh, okay. All right.
Like at
she
the White House?
I immediately assumed it was.
Yeah, I got immediately offended. I'm like, what the fuck is he using my videos for? Like, I didn't do anything.
Thin.
Well, it's 11 and it's been 2 hours, so I'm calling it because.
Alright, get out of here then.
I like sleeping.
Yeah.
Bye.
Y'all motherfucking go live.
Hey, could have just fucking left.
Thanks for having me.
I want to run the stream. Thank you for having. Toast, you got anything to shout out? Even though your channel's bigger than ours.
No,
not jealous.
Just doing my normal stuff.
Go fuck yourself. What?
Yeah, normal stuff.
Mo, you got anything to
shout out? Yeah, I'm just doing my normal stuff. So definitely subscribe to everybody here.
Yeah.
I have a bunch of people. Like featured on my channel, so
happy birthday, Billy! Bless Grampy Lobster with the soup, and
There's going to be one of those. DC Meter Girl, anything to shout out?
I do. My channel is on call for Grampy Lobster whenever he's up and feeling up to it. We're going to do live Grampy Lobster blowout, anal blowout sales.
Nice.
On the channel. So definitely keep in contact with that so you can hang out with your Grampy and have a good time. And you could tell him just how much he has caused you to be an alcoholic. Also, fuck you, Billy.
Why are you talking about me? Why are you bringing me up in this?
And well, because I know that Billy and Asia Wheeler have been systematically using racism to fuck with me. So I'm going to be exposing them in a series of videos. Yeah, act like you don't know that, bitch. It's okay. Whatever.
Actually don't. All right. Stupid call. Wilson, you got anything to shout out?
Yeah. Everyone who is not subscribed to Nova Ray, go ahead and subscribe to Nova Ray. Because she is the far superior version of Miss Parker in every way, shape, form, and fashion.
I knew it was going
to
happen.
Midwest, you got anything to shout out?
Oh, shit, son.
These are utter lies right here. All of you up in this panel bullying this poor, poor special needs person. How dare you do that?
That's actually kind of true.
Why do you have the nerve? This is why I'm here, to protect free speech. Because you are you're impugning his free speech is what you're doing. Impugning. I just learned that word. Anyway, so. Hey, don't you mock me. Listen here.
There it is.
You don't want to see me when I'm mad, because then I'll start going into a transformation. Like right now. You want to see it?
Yes.
Also, fuck you, headphone users.
What the hell was that?
I can't orgasm.
I'm now in my...
Okay, folks, don't forget to subscribe, like the stream, subscribe to Midwest. He's the fuck out. I love all of you.
I just put my website in the chat.
And his web chat. Go to his website. Form.
You. I am now super.